everyone, welcome back. Earlier, you learned about air and water. Let's understand about soil in this video. Friends, we all like playing cricket, football. But where do you play all these games? Out on the ground. But have you ever thought what the ground is made up of? Soil, yes. But where does this soil come from? And what it consists of? If you look closely, what can you observe? Small particles in the soil. Is there anything other than this? No. But in addition to small particles, soil consists of microorganisms and humus. Humus is nothing but decay of living organisms, which makes the soil porous. The organisms living in soil cannot be seen with the unaided eyes, but can be seen with the help of microscope. So, what did you get to know? What is soil made of? The soil is made up of tiny particles, humus, and microorganisms. But friends, have you ever wondered where these small particles come from? Just think. Let's understand. You must have seen this kind of huge rocks. Generally, these rocks break into small particles and later form the soil. But how are these huge rocks crumbling? Think. These big stone breaks under the influence of sun, water, air, and living organisms. Let us see how. During daytime, the sun heats up the big stones and this makes the stones to expand. And during night, these stones cool down and contract. Since all parts of rock do not expand and contract at the same rate, this results in the formation of cracks and ultimately the huge rocks breaks up into smaller pieces. Many times, water gets filled in this crack and sometimes due to low temperature, it turns into ice, which makes the crack bigger. And finally, the stones break. Friends, what do you think? This flowing water can also break the stones? Yes, absolutely correct. Running water carries small stones with it, and when these stones collide with other big stones, they break it, and the water then takes these particles along with it and deposits it further down its path. Like water, air also blows the small particles and drops it somewhere else, resulting in the formation of soil. Friends, you will be surprised to know that living organisms also help in the formation of soil. But how? Let's understand. You must have seen such kind of green sheet on the surface of stones. Well, this is not a sheet. In fact, it's a microorganism called lichen. It grows on the surface of the stone and secretes certain chemicals which powders the rock surface and form a thin layer of soil. You must have seen many times that if a big tree is growing near a big stone, then the root of the tree penetrates inside the crack already present in the stone. So, what will happen? Well, as the roots grow, the crack will widen further and eventually break. So in this way, due to effect of sun, water, wind and microorganisms, larger rocks get converted into smaller and smaller parts and ultimately soil is formed. Friends, what can you tell by looking at the soil around you? In how many days it will be made? It takes years to form a thin layer of soil. Flowing water or wind can take away the small soil particles with them and can deposit them at some place. But what if the soil gets blown away? So, can you imagine what would happen? The rocky layer below the soil will be exposed and we will lose a valuable resource because very few plants grow in the rocky layer. Well, friends, this is nothing but soil erosion. The main reason of soil erosion is deforestation. Can you tell me how? Let's understand. The roots of the tree hold the soil tightly and protect it from being washed away. And if the trees are cut down, what will happen? There will be no roots to hold the soil tightly and it will get easily washed away, which will lead to soil erosion. Friends, soil is very useful to all. The trees get nutrition from the soil, and when human and animal consume the plants, the same nutrition comes into the body of the animals and humans. Apart from this, soil is also the home of many of the organisms. But what if the soil starts getting polluted? We all are facing lots of problems due to soil pollution. For example, low yield of crops, harmful diseases such as cancer. But do you know how the soil is getting polluted? The main cause of land pollution is the cutting of trees, use of pesticides and fertilizers in the fields. Can soil pollution be prevented? Yes, it can be prevented. Let us see how. Soil pollution can be prevented by using manure instead of fertilizers, by not dumping motor oil in the ground, by using biodegradable products, and by eating organic food that are grown without pesticides. So what did you learn in this video? Soil, how soil is formed, importance of soil and soil pollution. In the next video, we will study about biogeochemical cycles.